for loop, the syntax of the for loop is starts with for in round brackets, initialization of variables. Then this is what the condition. Condition it means this for loop is going to be executed till this condition is true. Once this condition is false, then your control of this loop will be turned outside. Okay, ज्यावेळेस ही तुमची condition, if it goes false, that means let's say the value of I will reach to 10. Okay, as I have used here increment operator, म्हणजे ज्यावेळेस I ची value ही 10 असेल, 10 किंवा 10 पेक्षा जास्त, then this condition is false, 10 is not less than 10, right? So your control will be outside of this for loop. Okay, and last part is your increment or decrement. So depends on this condition, the operation will be there. So in the body of this for loop is again denoted with the help of this open and close curly bracket, and it may contain statements, it may contain instructions, or it may contain some calculations. Okay, so this is the syntax of for loop. So yesterday we have seen some basic examples of for loop. Today we will have one or two examples of again for loop based on the logic. Okay, so create table of 2. Okay, I want to create table of 2. That means my output should be, okay, likewise I want output 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. Okay, I want my output should look this way. Samajhle ka? What is the program? Create table of 2. Mala 2 cha kay karayche, pada tayar karayche. Mhanje maza output kay paise? Output he asa disla paise mala output. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. So, just give a try. I will wait for some time and then we will discuss. Okay, just give a try. I want to check whether you really understand the concept of for loop or not. Okay. Few students have attempted. Okay, few of you have attempted. So I will just write here code. For loop, and then I will initialize I is equal to, let's say, 0. Less than 21, I plus plus, then the body of for loop. In the for loop again I will make calculation, number is equal to number into I. Then I'm going to print the value. Enter. Here I'm going to print percent D, and the result is stored here in the number. Okay. Now for this number, I'm going to take value from the user. Enter. Number for table. See, I have not written printer in here in round bracket, double inverted comma. So that is why that for has changed the color. Okay, enter any number for. And routing table. And I'm going to text value. I'm going to scan it. I'm going to scan from the user person B and person, and I'm going to store into number variable. Yes, I have made comma, so the syntax is semicolon. Let's say 2. White print 0.
Sir, because I is equal to 0 and
I has not incremented. Just a minute, I will check. No, it gives some garbage value. Okay, here I have assigned value, enter any. Okay, I'm scanning the value for I have initialized to 1. I is going to be incremented. And the value of I is less than 21. This condition is also true. Then it prints this. Okay.
Sir, number is equal to zero. Declare के लेना है. Declare the number का.
एक minute. Or should I change? Okay. So let's try with this. Number is equal to number into into I. So when the value of I is incremented, it will work. This is not the problem is not here. The problem is somewhere. Okay, I will check with this logic. Meanwhile, I will go to some other logic. Program can be solved with multiple logic. Okay, no need to stuck with only one. Okay, now. See, for this, okay, I need to start with 2. Yes, my output should start with 2, so I initialize the value 2. Okay, so it will print it. Yes, then it will print this value. Then I will not print this. Now here I will print the value of I. First it will print the value of I, that is 2. Then yes, it will increment, but again it is not in the multiple of 2. So I need to change here. I is equal to I plus. Okay, and here okay, I will write 2. Okay, now the answer is here, but I need to use slash n, so it will be in the next line. Okay, no need to stick with one. I will just check like the formula was correct. Number is equal to number into the value of I. Value of I will be incremented by 1. Okay, in the previous example. But where it gets wrong, that I will check. But need not to be waste time here. Okay. So this way. Now this is one of the solution. Now I want output. I want output in the. आता मला असं नको आहे आउटपुट. वॉट आय वॉन्ट, लेट से इफ आय एम हॅविंग, नाव दिस इज टेबल करेक्ट, बट आय डोंट वॉन्ट, ओके जस्ट मी, आय डोंट वॉन्ट आउटपुट इन दिस वे. वॉट आय वॉन्ट आउटपुट लाईक 2 × 1 इज इक्वल टू 2, ओके, इन आवर रेग्युलर टेबल एज वॉट वी आर डूईंग. Like 2 × 2 is equal to 4. Then 2 × 3 is equal to 6. Likewise, I want up to 20. हाँ, समझ लाय का प्रॉब्लम काय करायचं आहे तुम्हाला. एका साइडला तुम्ही जी व्हॅल्यू घेणार यूजर कडून स्कॅन करून, ती तुमची ही लेफ्ट हँड साइडला राहणार, एकदम लेफ्ट हँड साइडला, बरोबर. इथे कुठली व्हॅल्यू येणार, ही चेंज झालेली 1, 2, 3, इथे व्हॅल्यू येणार ही या लूप मधल्या जे ची. एक मिनिट, मी प्रोग्राम दाखवतो मला, सॉरी. इथे जी व्हॅल्यू येईल इन्क्रीमेंट होऊन आय प्लस प्लस, म्हणजेच काय येणार आहे, तिथे आय ची व्हॅल्यू प्रिंट होईल. जी तुम्ही युजर कडून स्कॅन करून घेणार आहे व्हॅल्यू, ती कुठे येईल तुमची प्रोग्राम, हा ती व्हॅल्यू इथे येईल. आणि या दोघांचं कॅल्क्युलेशन काय असेल तर तुमचा इथे रिझल्ट असेल. समजला प्रोग्राम काय करायचं तुम्हाला? हॅलो, हा मी परत सांगतो, मला आउटपुट कसं पाहिजे. आता तुम्ही 2 चा टेबल लिहिला होता, बरोबर, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20 हे आउटपुट आले. पण आता मला तसं नको आहे आउटपुट. मला काय आउटपुट पाहिजे? 2 × 1 इज इक्वल टू 2, 2 × 2 इज इक्वल टू 4, 2 × 3 इज इक्वल टू 6, 2 × 4 इज इक्वल टू 8, असं मला आउटपुट पाहिजे. मग आता हे 2 कुठून आलं आहे सांगा? हे 2 मला 2 पाटा पाहिजे, बरोबर, 2 टेबल पाहिजे. हे कसं आलं आहे? हे युजर कडून घेतली मी व्हॅल्यू, बरोबर. सो मला 2 काय पाहिजे? 2 टेबल क्रिएट करायचं आहे. मग फर्स्ट व्हॅल्यू कुठली प्रिंट होणार आहे? तुमची युजरकडून आलेली. त्याच्यानंतर इथे काय प्रिंट होणार आहे? तुमचं इन्क्रीमेंट झालेलं ऑपरेशन. इन्क्रीमेंटमध्ये इन्क्रीमेंट काय होतं आपल्या इथं? आय प्लस प्लस. सो व्हॅल्यू कशाची येणार मग इथे? एक मिनिट, आय प्लस प्लस. सो इथे आय ची व्हॅल्यू, फर्स्ट व्हॅल्यू काय येईल? लेट से आता मी युजरकडून नंबर घेतलाय, फर्स्ट पर्सेंट डी इज फॉर द युजर, देन सेकंड पर्सेंट डी इज फॉर is for what? This operation, or you can say the value for this variable I is equal to percent %d. This is what your third variable. आता third variable मध्ये इथं तुम्ही जो फॉर्म्युला लिहिणार त्याच्यासाठी, सो ते व्हेरिएबल इथे येणार. लेट से आय हॅव गिवन द नेम एज ए, ओके. सो द आता ए साठी तुम्हाला काय कॅल्क्युलेशन करायचं आहे ते, तो तेच फक्त आता लॉजिक आहे. आय हॅव गिवन यू द प्रिंट एफ स्टेटमेंट, की हे तुम्ही जर प्रिंटेपमध्ये लिहिलं तर तुम्हाला प्रिंट येईल. आता ए साठी कॅल्क्युलेशन काय करायला लागेल बघा, आणि मला पाठवा, टेक्स्ट करा. समजलाय प्रोग्राम काय करायचं आहे तुम्हाला? हॅलो,
येस.
हा, मला 2 टेबल लिहायचं आहे. फक्त टेबल लिहिताना काय करायचं आहे? या वेमध्ये 2 × 1, 2 × 2, 2 × 3, 2 × 4 आणि देअर आन्सर ॲट द राईट हँड साईड, ओके. So start doing the program. If you check the screen, I already mentioned more than, let's say 80% code here. Only thing you need to write the logic, or you can say the calculation, to find out this table. Okay. How you are going to calculate value of A? So if you write this, you will get the answer. That is only remaining. So don't take much time. Okay. So everyone look at here. See, only you need to add a is equal to, as I'm going to use the value of a, I also need to declare it here a, and here a is equal to, okay, now check, I want number into, yes, the value, incremented value, right, number into I, then it is going to be taken here. Let's say I'm going to take the value from user, that is 2. 2 into what is the value of I? Now here I need to change, make corrections. 1, and I need to up to 20. Okay, so 2 into 1. Okay, 2 tens are. So I need here 11. Okay, that means it will run till I is less than 11, that means 10. 10 into 2, it will get 20. Okay, so I will run now program. Let's say 2. 2 into 1 is equal to 2. 2 into 2, 4. 2 into 3, 6. See, I have taken the value in the number variable. That number variable I have printed first. Then the value of I, which is going to be incremented by 1, that is with this increment operator, and I have used the second percent d for this I variable, and a, I have stored the value of this calculation number into I. Okay, so the result of number into I is going to be stored here in a, and it will get printed in the first. Then again it will increment I with 1. Now instead of 1, the value of I is 2. 2 is less than 11, then it will execute 2 into 2. Value of a will be 4. So it will print 2, 2, and 4. It will go as it is, I is incremented. So next I value will be 3. 3 is less than 11. That is true, condition is true. It goes in the body of this for loop. Number, that is 2 into 3, is equal to 6. So value of a will be 6, number is 2, I is 3, and value answer will be 6. Likewise, this for loop is going to be executed repeatedly till this condition occurs. Okay, what is the termination condition? When I is less than 11, when value reached to 11, I value will be reached to 11, so it will not execute it. It will be outside this for loop. So I will write a printf statement. Okay, give a simple message. We are out of for loop. Okay. Let's say if I give 3, now it will write 3 into. Okay. If I give here any value, let's say 5 into. Okay, as I have not mentioned slashing, so it takes the value 5 into 1, 5, and then remaining. Okay, so have you understood this? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now there is one more question for you, problem statement. Okay, I want output. Okay, I will give you the output. I want output in this way. 0, 0, 0. Okay, then 1, 2, 3. Then 2, 4, 6, 3, 6, 9. Okay, 4, 8, 12. Okay, I want my output in such way. Okay, I will make one more tab. What I will do, I will write in the table so there will not be any mistakes.
Correct minute, the program da kona.
Okay, just a minute. I will show it to you. 0, 0, 0. Here I want 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that means it I need to be incremented. Now here it need to be multiple of 2, 8. Now this multi need to be multiple of 3. Okay, sorry. No. Okay, I want this as a output. मला हे आउटपुट मध्ये पाहिजे. Okay, my output should be like this way. This is for your homework. Okay, now I will stop the recording.